Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Good evening, good evening, good evening to each and every one of you, the children of the Most High God. Welcome to the locker room where foundational teaching takes place. Listen, I need for you all as you're coming in to dust your feet up at the door by liking the broadcast, sharing the broadcast, prepare your heart and mind to receive what thus says the Lord. Meaning, get your Bible, get your note-taking material, get your outline, because we're going to go deeper into the biblical form of praise.
And most of all, while you're getting ready, get your praise together. Come on, put your hands together. Come on in, like, share, comment, say good evening, and get everything ready so we can jump into the Word.
Gracious to us.
He has.
He's kept us. He's covered us. All year long.
All year long. It has been 1 year to remember. Yeah. But God has definitely shown us miracles, signs, and wonders on this year. And we praise Him for it.
Amen. We thank God because at the beginning of 2020, but actually at the end of 2019,
right.
it was deposited in my spirit.
Yes.
Amen. For the congregation, for Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries worldwide, that this, the 2020 was the year of confirmation.
Yes.
Miracles, signs, yes, and wonders. This was before we knew anything about the pandemic. Mm. This is before the economic decline. This is before the stock market crash. This is before over a quarter million people lost their lives,
wow,
amen, to COVID-19.
Yeah.
This was before all of this madness that took place in the earth in the year 2020. But yet and still, we believe the word of God.
The word of God still stands.
That this was the year of confirmation, miracles, signs, and wonders, because
yes,
in the midst of the storm, in the midst of the fire, in the midst of whatever we
God has been faithful. He's kept us.
He's kept us. He's covered us. And we just want to tell the Lord, thank you. So if you're watching tonight, or if you're watching in the future, amen, of this broadcast, I just want you to just take a moment and just say, Lord, I thank you for what you've done. I thank you for keeping me and covering us. Lord, I thank you for things aren't as well
as
they are, because things could have been a whole lot worse, but yet and still His grace and His mercy has kept us. And Lord, we say thank you.
We say thank you.
With grateful hearts, we say thank you. Yes, we may have lost loved ones this year. We may have lost our jobs, our homes, finances, insurance, whatever may have been the case that we went through, but yet and still we're here. So Lord, we say thank you, because we understand, according to Romans 8:28, all things
work
together for good to them who love the Lord, who are called according to His purpose. We also understand that His ways are not our ways, His thoughts are not our thoughts. So we don't know what God was doing in the earth or why things have to be as they are.
As they are.
But God has a great plan for us, a future and a hope, an expected end.
That's it.
For those of us who are yet here, we praise God for that. I pray right now that God comforts those of you who have lost loved ones, who dealt with this disease, this virus.
Yes.
We're praying for consolation for you and your family, for those who have lost homes or jobs or whatever may be the case. I know that God is a supplier of all of our needs, and I also know God is a restorer.
Yes.
So we want to go to God in prayer. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for who you are. You are the great I am, God.
Yes.
We understand that you know all things, and your way is perfect. Your way, your will is perfect,
yes,
and your word is perfect. God, we ask now that you would give us understanding, that you would give us clarity of thought and of speech,
yes,
God,
Lord,
to articulate that which you have for your people. Reveal yourself.
Thank you,
tonight, God, in us and through us. Reveal yourself on the airwaves, God,
you,
so that those who are watching, those who are tuned in, can see you, they can hear you,
yes,
they can feel you in your power,
yes,
and in your love, in
you,
the name of Jesus.
Name
we
of
pray
Jesus
right now that you would lead us and guide us into all truth. Lead
yes
us into the pathway in which we should go. Lead us
thank
down
you
the path, up the pathway of righteousness,
yes,
in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we understand that you have allowed us to be here tonight, God, for a purpose and for a reason.
Yes.
And we praise you for it right now, that you have allowed us, God, to see the last Tuesday in 2020. God, we praise you for it right now in the name of Jesus. We ask that you rest over this class, rest over the people.
Thank you.
We plead the blood of Jesus against the enemy. Satan, the Lord, rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We come against every distraction, every hindering spirit, every negative thought, every negative word, every negative situation, every negative condition right now.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, we speak life. Hallelujah. And we rebuke that spirit of death right now. We speak joy.
Joy.
And we rebuke that spirit of depression right now. We speak stability. And we rebuke that spirit of instability right now in the name of Jesus. We speak faith. And we rebuke that spirit of fear in the name of Jesus. As a matter of fact, we speak wealth and prosperity.
Thank you, God.
And we rebuke that spirit of poverty and lack.
Thank you, in Jesus' mighty name.
Let the church say thank God.
Thank God. And amen.
Can you turn it up a little bit, Dr. Clay? We just thank God for each and every one of you tuning in with us here in the locker room. The foundational teaching takes place, y'all. We have an announcement that we want to share with you concerning the upcoming service. It's going to be
Thursday. Right upon us.
Yes, and I am so excited. You excited?
I'm excited.
Amen. So we are certainly excited. So we pray that you all take notes, that you will set your alarm, mark your calendar and set your alarm, and we'll be right back after these messages. Amen. Some important information with you.
Very important. New Year's Eve celebration, the crossover.
Yes.
Join us Thursday, December 31st at 7 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time,
yes,
and 11 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time.
We're looking for an epic time in the Lord. We understand that we are in a pandemic and many of us will be home, but fret not, because two times on New Year's Eve, we're going to be going live for the crossover at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. And for our late night people, you know, the people that like to get up late at night.
The night owls.
That's what it's called, the night owls. You'll be able to tune in at 11 p.m. Central Standard Time right here on Facebook Live, as well as on our Twitter account at APWM. Worldwide. Be a part of what God is doing as we cross over into 2021. Y'all, 2020 has been something else.
It has been something else, but it's been something else.
Yeah, it has.
So we have to admit that 2020 has taught us lots of things, but we're looking forward to what God is going to do in 2021. I have some of my own visions and revelations as to what's going to go on in 2021, but I'm not going to share that with you right now. You have to tune in with us for a word and a praise at the crossover.
Listen, y'all, listen. God has blessed in a tremendous way. I know so many things have happened in the year 2020.
Right.
But God has kept us for a reason.
Yeah.
He has sustained us for a reason.
Yes.
He has allowed us to make it to this day for a reason. What am I saying? God has a purpose in store for each and every one of us.
Yes.
So we are looking to cross over, y'all,
into
2021 with praise, with a relevant word in celebration of what God has done for us.
And don't forget, with power and authority.
Power. Can somebody shout power?
Power.
And authority.
And authority.
So we thank God for you. Make sure you set your alarm. Make sure you mark your calendar to be a part of the crossover. It is going to be amazing. And we're praising God in advance for what He is going to
do. What He's
going
to do. Remember, set your alarm for the crossover Thursday, December 31st, 2020 at 7 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time and 11 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time.
So we love you. Praise God. I am Senior Pastor ML Clay.
And I'm Dr. Kimberly Clay, the Executive Pastor.
So we welcome you to Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries Worldwide, the crossover, New Year's Eve.
Yes.
See you there. God bless you. God for you all. We ask that you govern
yourselves accordingly.
Yourselves accordingly and lead us for the crossover.
Yes.
Thursday evening at 7 p.m. or you can tune in with us for our night owls.
The night owls, 11 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time.
We're in for a blessed time in God. We want to cross over together.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We've been in this thing together, y'all. So we're gonna cross over together as one big happy family. So make sure you share, you invite others, you tag others to be a part of the crossover 2020. You can go to my personal page, amen, and get the information to share it to your page. You can go to our ministry page, APWM Conway. share the commercial. Listen, we want to do all that we can to digitally evangelize. Digital evangelism. So help us get the information out to be together at the crossover, y'all. 2020, Thursday, December 31st at 7 p.m. and at 11 p.m. Central Standard Time.
Amen. We're excited. Join us.
Amen. Well, we honor God for tonight as we're going into part three of the biblical forms of ministry. Praise. Amen.
The biblical forms of ministry. Wow. Now that just came in my spirit right then. Had to look at his paper.
The biblical forms of
the biblical forms of ministry.
I taught it already.
Oh, wow.
It was a workshop.
Oh, wow.
Were you there? Lord have mercy.
I just was hearing it. What is the Lord saying?
Yeah. Okay. Amen. So we thank God for each and every one of you, y'all. We want to jump into this, the biblical forms of praise, part three.
Part three. Good evening again, family. So excited to have each of you here with us for the fellowship, for the learning. This is the locker room where foundational teaching takes place. We thank God for building our firm foundation in the Word. So we're learning in this Principles of Praise and Worship series that we've been on for several months, and we thank God for it. Yeah. We are now in the biblical forms of praise, part three. And tonight, we're going into standing and clapping. Standing and clapping. We're going to talk about these biblical forms of praise to close out our year. And we're so excited about what God is saying in his word. So standing. Standing is a bit more common form of praise than some. But we need to increase our times of standing before the Lord in worship. Sometimes we get comfortable. We get comfortable sitting just in service, and we kind of get relaxed. And I said myself as a worship leader, let's relax on our feet, because it is a scientific fact that we're relaxed when we're standing, not when we're sitting. The pressure is on our spine when we sit. That's why we have to get up and walk around. But standing is a more common praise than maybe dancing or other forms. But these are all to be used in conjunction together to give God praise. So sometimes after we stand for a while, we become self-conscious and think we're getting tired. Can you believe that? We think in our minds that we're getting tired. Even then, we should remain on our feet, because standing is an act of honor. So standing before the Lord, we do it when we read the scriptures. Before Pastor brings the word, we always make sure that we stand to read the word of the Lord together to honor his word, but we stand to honor him. We stand in worship because it shows respect for our God.
Amen. So now we're understanding the reason why when it's time for the praise and worship.
Yes.
That the congregation stands.
Yes.
The reason why we're standing, because it's a biblical form of praise. And so they're getting up, the choir standing to sing, amen, and the song will start, you know, they'll start the song, the music jumping, the lead singer starts singing, and people are getting up there standing and clapping. Why? Because it's a biblical form of praise. Yes. Some of us stand because the music is good, or you know how it is, the music group, that's my song, or whatever be the case, or we're feeling good, so we will stand and get with what's going on. But standing, it's literally a biblical form of praise.
It is.
And it helps us to enjoy the outpouring of the presence of God. Why? Because we are more receptive. We are more open versus we're sitting down with our arms folded and, you know, closed off. Can't nothing get in, can't nothing get out. But if we're standing, we're open, we're clapping, we're praising God. So now as the Spirit of God is moving and we're open, then he's able to pour into us, into our situation, amen, into our causes. Listen, we may come in sick, but because I'm praising God with the little strength that I have, guess what happens? I become stronger and stronger, because we are made stronger in his might. Our weakness, his strength is made perfect in our weaknesses so we become stronger and stronger in God. I wish I had somebody that could just type across the screen, I'm a witness. Oh, if you know what I'm talking about, that you went to church and you weren't fitting your very best, but because you were standing with the little strength that you have had, giving God the glory, the honor, and the praise that he deserved, regardless of how I feel. Before I knew it, I was dancing and shouting around the church. I forgot I was sick. I forgot my head hurt, my leg hurt. I forgot that my asthma was acting up. Because I got lost in the praise of the Lord God.
Yes. Amen. That's it right there. Let's go to Deuteronomy 10 and 8. Let's see what the Lord is saying about standing.
Yes.
We always go to the word to verify what the Lord has given us in the formal study. So we're going to find out in Deuteronomy 10 and 8. Old Testament, is it the fourth book of the Bible?
Amen. You asking me?
It's the fifth book of the Bible.
Who you asking?
Deuteronomy.
I know I preach, but don't be asking me which book is this, the 55th book in the what?
Oh my God.
Don't do me.
Come on, man, read.
Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 8. At that time, I hope y'all are there. Dr. Clay is rushing. I hope y'all have found it. Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 8. She's the teacher. Okay. At that time, amen. At that time, the Lord separated the tribe of Levi.
Mm-hmm.
To bring the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord, to stand before the Lord, to minister unto him, and to bless him, and to bless his name unto this day. Let me say it again. At that time, the Lord separated the tribe of Levi to bear the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord, to stand before the Lord, to minister unto him, and to bless in his name unto this day.
Let's stay right there in Deuteronomy 10 and 8. Let's go to the Message translation. I so often like to use the Message. It says, that's when God set apart the tribe of Levi to carry God's covenant chest, to be on duty in the presence of God, to serve him, and to bless his name, as they continue to do today. I'm going to read it again. That's when God set apart the tribe of Levi to carry God's covenant chest, to be on duty in the presence of God, to be on duty or to stand in the presence of God, standing on duty in honor of the Lord, and to bless his name as they continue to do today. It said to serve him, to bless his name, standing is a part of us blessing God. Standing is a part of us giving him honor. Standing is a part of being on duty in the presence of God. Standing means I'm not sitting, I'm not relaxed in God's presence. It shows that I am honored to be in his presence. Therefore, I stand. If any of you know anything about chivalry and showing honor as far as a man to a woman, when a woman approaches a table, this is some of the lost art of the world, lost art of etiquette. When a woman approaches, a man stands to honor her. He stands to show honor to her. So why would we not stand to honor God? It's even in his word that we stand to show that we're on duty, that we're ready to serve him. We're ready to be who we need to be, where we need to be, when we need to be. We're standing, showing that we're on duty, we're on God's guard, we're blessing him, and we're ready to serve.
Amen.
We're ready to serve. Another, did you have something?
No, ma'am.
Another example, I want to run through this because I want to show several examples in the Bible of standing as a biblical form of praise. 1 Chronicles 23 and 30. Y'all come on, y'all got to come on with me real quick. 1 Chronicles 23 and 30. I wanted to make sure that we finished these two important biblical forms of praise on tonight before finishing out the year. 1 Chronicles 23 and 30.
Not 1 Corinthians.
Yes, the old.
But we're in the Old Testament, 1 Chronicles. What book is that, Dr. Clay? Which book is that?
Oh.
1 Chronicles chapter 23 and 30. Come on, administrators. Y'all been sleeping lately now. We're going to end the year strong. We're going to end the year strong, administrators. 1 Chronicles chapter 23, verse 30, the King James verses. And to every, Lord have mercy, let me get this big old eye right here.
Oh, yeah.
And to stand every morning to thank and praise the Lord, and likewise at evening, or at even, meaning at evening. Let me read it again. And to stand every morning to thank and praise the Lord, and likewise at even.
Okay, right there. To even break it down more in the Message translation, stay right there. 1 Chronicles 23 and 30. Honor to each of you who are just joining us. We're on the Biblical Forms of Praise, part 3, talking about standing as a biblical form of praise. And we're in the Word in 1 Chronicles 23, verse 30. In the Message translation, it says, also, they were to be present for morning prayers, thanking and praising God, for evening prayers, and at the service of the whole burnt offerings to God on Sabbath, at new moons, and at all festivals. So basically, the word was saying that it was lining out the purpose for Aaron and the Levites' work. It was saying they were to be present for morning prayers. This was the guidelines. Morning prayers, thanking and praising God. Evening prayers. How many of us give God a morning prayer? We pray to him in the morning, fellowship with him, commune with him in the morning, as well as the evening prayers. Standing to give him praise, standing in honor of him, in all of our ways, acknowledging him, knowing that he's a great God, he's a mighty God. Yes. So I stand in your presence to give you honor. That's a way to show God that I'm not just relaxing in your presence, God. I want to do everything right. I want to stand with my brothers and sisters and to show you that I love you and that we love you.
Amen.
Amen. 1 Chronicles 23 and 30. That's the second reference scripture that we have. Nehemiah 9 and 5. We're still in the Old Testament. The Old Testament is full of the praise and worship examples of the Bible. Nehemiah 9 and 5. Nehemiah 9 and 5. We're going to go there to see what the Lord is saying. Nehemiah is after Ezra. Not one of the more commonly read books of the Bible, but we have to learn them all. Nehemiah 9 and 5. Administrators, y'all got us? Okay, let's read.
Then the Levites, Jeshua, and Kadmiel, Bani, Hashab, Nia, Sherebiah, come on somebody, Hodijah, Shabaniah, and Pethinahiah said, so listen, y'all, don't let it beat you down. We can do this too. Then the Levites, said, stand up and bless the Lord your God forever and ever. Why am I standing straining like this, Lord Jesus? And blessed by thy glorious name, which is exalted above all blessing and praise.
Amen. I like that. And then you can also say the Levites, all of their names, and just start reading. We can make it easy, class, because sometimes the Old Testament names are hard to pronounce. We can just know that it's the Levites.
Okay, check this out then. Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 5, in part B of the text reads, stand up.
That's it.
And bless the Lord your God forever and ever. And blessed be thy glorious name, which is exalted above all blessing and praise. Amen.
In the Message translation, starting at part B of the text, it says, blessed be your glorious name, exalted above all blessing and praise. You're the one, God.
Yes.
You alone. That's the point. of the scripture. Blessed be your glorious name. God, we're standing together in unity to say, blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Exalted above all blessing and praise. You're the one, God, you alone. You get the glory, you get the honor, you get the praise.
Yes.
It all belongs to you. So that's what they were saying in Nehemiah. All those names of those different Levites, Hodiah and Shebaniah and Pethahiah. On your feet, bless God forever and ever because he is worthy. God, we bless your holy name. We're not standing for this one, that one, or the other one. We're standing for you. God and God alone gets the glory out of our lives. Is that it?
Amen.
Amen. That's Nehemiah 9:5. And we have one more scripture to show where God orders us to stand as a biblical form of praise. Psalm 134:1. Psalm number. We have grown to love the book of Psalms as a class in the locker room, knowing that this is the book of songs and hymns written mostly by Brother David, King David, in all of his good times and his bad times. We have learned that there are many songs, poems, and hymns in the book. Psalm 134:1. Psalm 134:1.
Behold, bless ye the Lord, all ye servants of the Lord, which by night stand in the house of the Lord.
Oh, wow. In the Message translation, it says, come, bless God, all ye servants of God. Let me start over. Come, bless God, all you servants of God, you priests of God, posted to the night watch in God's temple. Come, bless God, all you servants of God, the priests of God, posted to the night watch. Posted to the night watch. That goes back to our first scripture in Deuteronomy 10. I'm standing guard. I'm on duty to praise you. I'm on duty in God's temple. I'm on duty to do whatever needs to be done. And right now, praise and worship needs to be done. I stand in the presence of you, God. I stand. We're talking about standing. Yes, we clap. Yes, we sing. We play our instruments, but we're standing is actually a biblical form of praise that we cannot turn down on. We can't just take it lightly. Standing means a lot. When we're together corporately, standing to say, God, we stand in solidarity, in honor of you.
Yes.
We stand together in all of you. So let's keep it in mind that standing is very important in our times of worship. Let's not be perturbed or frustrated because the worship leader says, let's stand to give God praise. Let's stand to honor him. Let's stand to sing praises unto his name. We are not getting tired. Tell yourself, I'm not getting tired when I stand up. I'm not getting tired because God is so worthy.
Well, I've noticed people get tired, and so a lot of times when I know we've been standing for a while, we've become accustomed to it in Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries. But I say, Lord, give them strength in their legs. Lord, strengthen their back, Lord, because we're accustomed to it. And so we're praising God. We're lifting up our hands. We're clapping. We're screaming. We're shouting. We're running. Amen. Because we are excited.
Amen.
Amen. About what God is saying, what God is downloading to us, what God is doing. And so we can't be still. I think it was Jeremiah saying it's like fire. Hey, shut up in my bones. So I've never known of somebody who was literally on fire. And they were just sitting there just chilling with fire coming out of their bosom. They was up moving around, y'all.
That's it.
Because the fire was hot.
It's hot.
Amen. I'm not a cook, but if I put my hand on the stove or pot, I know to quickly move my hand. And I'm doing this, trying to cool it off.
Yes.
And so the fire is hot.
It's hot.
In Anointed Praise and Worship Ministry. So we are used to standing, to running, to moving, to praising and worshiping the Lord thy God because God is so hot, y'all.
He's so hot.
He's hot.
On fire. So biblical forms of praise, there it is, standing. Mm-hmm. It's so important. Let's implement that into our, even our times of praise on our own. Lord, I'm standing. Let's make it deliberate and on purpose. God, I'm standing in honor of you. God, I'm standing, making a point in my life to stand before you. Okay, so here we are to clapping our hands. So look, standing and clapping our hands are two biblical forms of worship, but guess what? They go together. Stand and clap. We stand up and clap our hands when the praise and worship is going forth. When the choir is singing, we stand and clap our hands to show God that we're ready. Like Pastor said, we're ready and available for what God is doing in us. We're ready. God, my body is ready. I'm in a posture where I'm ready for you to use me as you will. I'm here and I'm available to you. So let's talk tonight about clapping our hands, because this takes the standing to another level. When I stand, then what do I do once I'm standing? We're talking about praise and worship, talking about honoring God. So standing and clapping our hands go together. Psalm number 47, verse 1. Psalm number 47, verse 1. Let's go there. Come on, administrator. Psalm number 47, verse 1. Clapping our hands. Did we have any idea of the connection that's here? We're going to learn more tonight about fully understanding why it's important to clap our hands. Clapping. Psalm 47 and 1. Are y'all there?
Amen.
Type amen if you're there. Type amen. We're trying to take you with us as we go into the further part of our lesson. Let's read.
Listen, y'all, we're in the locker room. This is not a spectator sport.
It's not, yeah.
Amen. To be a champion, listen, we got to get to the drawing board. We got to participate.
Yes.
We all got to put in. It's just like on any team, we all got to exercise. We all got to sweat. We all got to run. We all got to lift weights. And according to what sport we're playing, we all got to shoot the basketball, yes, dribble the basketball, pass the ball. So we have to be engaged, amen, in order to grow together and mend as that championship team, the army of the Lord, in which God has called us to be soldiers,
yes,
in the army of the Lord. So here, soldiers, amen, who came with your weapons on tonight.
Yes.
Psalm 47 and verse 1. I'm talking about your Bible, not your gun.
Oh, Lord.
Or your dual knife, your dual switchblade. Oh, but we're talking about the word of God. Psalm 47 and 1 says, oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. So, oh my God. Clap your hands, all ye people. So when we say, come on, give God some praise. Come on, put your hands together. Clap your hands and bless the name of the Lord. We're not just saying it to do it just to do it, just to make noise. But the Bible declares it's a biblical form of praise. Oh, it says, oh, clap your hands, all ye people. So that's not just the praise team. That's not just the worship leader. That's not just for the preacher.
Wow.
But that's for everybody to put your hands together like the devil's head is between them.
Yes.
And clap hands, all ye people. And while we're clapping, we're not just standing there just clapping absent-mindedly.
Yes.
But it said, shout unto God with the voice of triumph. So I'm screaming, I'm shouting, I'm applauding, y'all. I'm praising and worshiping God at the same time that I'm standing, I'm clapping my hand, and my mouth is open wide, blessing the name of Jesus with the voice of triumph. Question is, are you triumphant? Come on.
Yes.
Do you feel victorious?
And
I'm going to go beyond the feeling. I know we're going to teach this thing.
Yeah.
I'm going to go beyond the feeling, because sometimes we get lost in emotionalizing the situation. God can tell us to emotionalize it. He said, in the good times, praise him, in the bad, I will bless the Lord
in all times.
And his praise shall
continually be in my mouth.
Be in my mouth. So therefore, I may not feel, it's not a predicated upon our feelings, but we will shout unto God, the one who is victorious, the one who said we are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. We want to shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Now, when we are triumphant, Dr. Clay, we don't have a weak shout. We don't have a weak praise. We're not just murmuring, you know, No, no, we are screaming. We are hollering. The veins, y'all, come on, y'all. Y'all know. We got the big veins in our neck, vein coming. Someone got the vein coming down the middle of our head. We're screaming because we have won. Can you imagine? Yes, we don't gamble. We don't do scratch-offs. At least we're not supposed to. But if somebody came, amen, and blessed you with $1 million, for some folk, $1 million is chump change. But for those who, amen, who are just $2 above broke, $1 million can change the trajectory of your life and your in your lineage. And so now you have won something. I can only imagine, my God, how undignified we would look, amen, if we just won $1 million, amen. Or the lawyer called us and said you had a great uncle or your great grandma Gina side. You're like, who is Gina? And they left you $1 million. We don't even mind who Gina was. I got a what for real? Yes, your name is so-and-so, so-and-so. This is your social security number. This is your mama. And they're going to give you the rundown of all the people. So you know they're not lying. And they said, come on over to the office to sign these papers to get this. Listen, I can hear how loud we are screaming. I'm just going to use my lesson as a check. And we got the documents right here. They're saying, listen, I'm the beneficiary of this, that, and the other. I can imagine how loud our mouths would be, praise God, because we have the victory. So he said, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Listen, this is Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries. I thank God for our family, friend, and guests who are tuned in this evening. But listen, we are to have the loudest churches, the loudest buildings. What the club look like being louder than the church?
Yes.
Oh my God. We can go to the club, the music beating. We side by side. Come on, y'all. I can't even hear what she's saying. I'm all in her ear screaming. She in my, what you say? She in my ear screaming. The music is so loud. The people are so loud. But then I'm supposed to come into the house of God. It's like a museum. It's like I'm in a cemetery. You can't say nothing. You can't do nothing. You can't move. The devil is the light. God said there are biblical forms of praise in place for us to implement to run the devil up out of here, to run the devil out of Dodge, and we gonna clap our hands, all ye people.
I know y'all to try that out.
Amen. Can y'all just put your mics down? Or y'all don't have a mic, praise God. Just put your phone down, put it up on the stand. If you're watching your TV, turn the volume up. Woo. And just begin to get
hallelujah.
Glory. Thank you.
Thank you, God.
Thank you. Come on.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. That's what we do. That's what we're supposed to be doing in the church.
That's it. All the time. We may just be at home to ourselves and we just break out into praise. I think about what he's done and I just put my hands together and put my mouth on that thing and let the Lord know that, God, you've been too good for me to keep my mouth closed.
Yes.
You've been too good for me to hold my praise. You've been too good.
Yes.
So, God, I'm going to stand. I'm going to clap. I'm going to shout. I'm going to open my mouth and give you the glory.
Listen, y'all, don't get dry. Don't allow the pandemic to dry up your praise. Amen. I know we be tuned in online and various things like that, but do not allow the pandemic to take your praise, to choke out your praise. Amen. When I'm teaching, I be like, touch your neighbor. I don't know who all in your house. But I'm like, touch your neighbor, like the message this past Sunday. Touch your neighbor and say, calm down. I don't know who is in your house. It may just be your baby. It's your baby or infant. Can't even talk, but touch your baby anyway and say, calm. Damn, listen, when I'm like, give God the glory, give God the praise. Listen, I can't hear you, but God can hear you. Yeah. The angels of heaven can hear you, and the devil can hear you. Yeah. Giving God the glory, and he has to back up. The Bible says, submit ourselves unto God, resist the devil, and he will flee from us. So we're like, give God a hand clap of praise. I may not be able to see you. Some of y'all didn't even clap. You were just looking at us clap. Like, oh, they so cute. Look at them. Oh, my God. They so funny.
They can talk loud.
Clap your hands, amen, and give God the glory. You listen, we in the locker room, so we're practicing, amen. Yes. We're practicing and preparing for when we get back in the building, amen.
That's right.
So when we get in the building, we even stronger than we were when we left. More anointed than we were before, more focused than we were before, more ready, more hungry, thirstier than we were before. Yeah. Why? Because we've been practicing. So now that we get on the field, we won't fumble the ball. No, oh my God. We won't give the ball to the other team. Yeah. We won't fall. Oh my God. We won't fall victim because they stronger than us. They big and we're like X in their eyes. The devil is alive. He said, go and pursue. Oh my God, I'm about to preach this thing. Pursue this thing. Clap your hands.
That's what he said, Pastor. And we have to understand, y'all, this thing is serious. Mm-hmm. This is not to be taken lightly. When we say praise and worship is important, praise and worship is important. There is no way we could stay on this series for months and months and months at a time and still not be done. Is that it's so important. It's all over the Bible.
Yes, yes.
It's so, the principles of praise and God are so important till we have to get down and dig into that thing so that we can lay out the foundation for it, because without praise and worship, we have nothing to stand on.
Uh-huh.
Praise and worship brings us back into the presence of God. Where sin separated us, praise and worship brings us back. If we don't know the principles, if we don't know how to properly praise God, how in the world do we expect to be changed? Because remember, praise changes us. It doesn't change God. It brings us into his presence because we are changed. Because no unclean thing can dwell or stand in the presence of God. So the clapping, the singing, the standing, the opening our mouths, everything, it comes to bring us back into the presence of God. We are the one who drift off from him. He doesn't drift away from us. So we have to bring ourselves back under submission and to come into his presence. And praise reminds us of the goodness of Jesus. Praise reminds us, when I'm clapping my hands, I'm letting God know that, God, I love you, but it's also reminding me that I love him, and there is a way that I ought to conduct myself before the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let's go to Psalm 98:8. Psalm 98:8. Thank you, Pastor, for that revelation as to the clapping and the opening our mouths. Psalm 98:8. As you're going there, as the administrators are posting for us, I want to share with you, clapping is a show of approval and appreciation. Clapping, it is a show. It shows that we approve and appreciate God. Yet many churches don't encourage people to clap their hands to the Lord. Isn't that something? Many churches don't even bother, don't even tell the people to clap, actually disapprove of it. Yet many churches, they don't encourage it. Those who omit clapping from their praise do themselves harm. We're going to learn more about this, because God is the one who determines how we should praise him.
Uh-huh.
We do ourselves harm by not clapping. Let's go to Psalm 98:8, and we're going to go deeper into the reason why we benefit our health in clapping.
Let's see. Psalm 98:8 reads, let the floods clap their hands. Let the hills be joyful together. Let me say it again. Let the floods, the rivers, clap their hands. Mm. Let the hills be joyful together.
This is good. Now, Psalm 98:8 in the message, it says, let ocean breakers call out encore, and mountains harmonize the finale.
Let ocean breakers call out encore. The ocean breakers, the ocean waves cascading. And mountains harmonize the finale. If we look at this in a pictorial illustration, we will see that the ocean has waves as the wind. All of this is created by God. The ocean has waves. There are peaks on the tops of the waves. Mm-hmm. They are shaped like the tips of hands. Mm-hmm. The ocean waves, let them even cry out, encore, clapping. They have waves. They have tips as hands. So God is showing, let everything that has breath, praise the Lord. Everything that I created has a way to praise me. The flowers, they even blow in the wind, giving God praise. Everything that he created has a purpose in this beauty of praising God, in the beauty of his holiness. The mountains have peaks on them. They are able to shout out encore. The tips of the mountains point up to God. They point upward to the Lord. As I was looking up under the praise, under the ocean, when I saw that about the peaks, and I looked at the mountains, he was referring to the peaks of the waves in the ocean as the wind hit them. And then the mountains, they all point straight up to God. Even in the way that they look, in the way that they stand mightily and majestically. I wanted to share this. Clapping has benefits that we don't fully understand. Make sure you got your note paper out, because this is something very important for us tonight. Studies done in Japan over the last 1,000 years have shown that our hands and feet contain nerves that attach to every organ in our body. Mm-hmm. When we walk, we are therefore stimulating all of our organs and giving life to them. God knew why he commanded us to raise our hands with clapping. He knew that when we clap, the nerves of our palms and the fingers stimulate our whole body, bringing us life. So clap your hands equals, quote, get life. Clap your hands equals get life. So in Japan, over the last 1,000 years, they've done studies and shown that there are nerves in our hands, there are nerves in our feet that connect to every organ in our body. God knew that by clapping, we were energizing, we were increasing blood flow, we were tapping into those nerves that made things pump and move and work right. Some of our problem a lot of times is that we don't move around enough, that we're too still, too stagnant, too still. That's why the doctors encourage exercise on a daily basis, but clapping actually has, our hands have nerves in them that attach to different organs in our body. So by clapping, we actually tap into those nerves in our palms.
That's good. That's really good.
We're learning on tonight that God has a purpose and a plan for everything. He gave man a beautiful mind to learn the mysteries of him. And this is one of the mysteries that they've discovered in the nerves in our hands. God created us as a beautiful living creature.
Yes.
Full of wisdom, full of knowledge and understanding. But we have to figure out the mysteries of God. There is a reason for everything that he tells us to do. Mm-hmm. God doesn't give us any empty instruction. That's he right. says to clap your hands. It's not just for him. It's for us as well. So just like the clapping, the praise changes us. The clapping has something to do. Every form of praise has something different to do in our body, and it has something different to do in our emotions, in our mind, in our relationship building with the Lord.
Amen. Now, the information she just shared, how many of y'all knew about this? Come on, y'all. That's why it's so vitally important for us to be in the locker room.
Yes.
Every Tuesday evening at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, where foundational teaching takes place, because this was some vital information that I know majority of us did not know.
I didn't know until my study.
The benefit of clapping our hands, what it does to our organs, because that is true. our feet and our hands, this certain pressure point that has to do with our liver, our kidneys, these various things that goes on in our bodies, you all. Mm-hmm. And so that's why it's so important to be in Bible class, y'all.
Yes.
It's one thing to tune in with us every Sunday morning at 9 a.m. Yes. Central Standard Time for our virtual worship celebration. We praise God for you. We love you. We have a glorious time in God together in the cyber sanctuary. But to come in and get this type of teaching right here, this will make disciples. A disciple is one who is a student. How can I be a disciple of Jesus Christ and I don't go to school? It's all right to read and study by yourself, but we need to be in class. Mm-hmm. We need to be pupils. Amen. We need to be disciplined ones. We need to sit underneath somebody to train us in the ways in which we should go, although we need to study out our Bibles.
That's it.
So that's why it's vitally important for us to be in the locker room. And I thank God for you all. Faith, you. We are really faithful attendees, and we praise God for your faithfulness. As a matter of truth, I need everybody right now to just stop what you're doing and to share this broadcast. Come on,
share.
We're going to go out of 2020. We're going to go hard. I need everybody right now to stop what you're doing. Don't be disobedient. Don't be hard.
Tell them, Pastor.
Take a moment. Push share. We're not going to teach nothing else. We're going to stop right here. We're going to go deeper, but we're going to give every person an opportunity to share the broadcast.
Yes.
Like the broadcast. Yes, like it. Give us a heart or a thumb. Like the broadcast. Then share the broadcast. That's all I need you to do. Like it. Then share it. Once you have done that, just put hashtag share it in the comment section. I need everybody to take a moment. I'm going to give you a good minute to do that.
Yes.
To like the broadcast, to share the broadcast. And then we're going to go deeper into the clapping of our hands being a biblical form of praise. But I need everybody to take this moment to do so. We have been blessed. Amen. With so many people who have been connecting to this great teaching, to the great gospel of Jesus Christ. And it's because of you.
Yes.
It's because of your obedience.
Yes.
Amen. To the call of evangelism.
Your excitement.
Amen. Amen. That others are finding out what's going on here in the house of God. It's not about my church. I don't have a church.
Yes.
Amen. I'm just allowed to, preach the good news of Jesus Christ here at Anointed Praise and Worship Ministry. So we just thank God for it. So like the broadcast, share the broadcast, push hashtag share. You got about 30 more seconds, y'all. So I'm waiting on you.
Yes.
Amen. Don't be hard-headed.
Yeah.
Don't be hard. Obedience is better than sacrifice, y'all. Some of y'all deep. So I got to give you a scripture. Amen.
Ooh.
Come on with this. Amen. We got about 15 more seconds.
Come on. Share.
Let me hit my coffee now. When I get through, we ought to be ready now. Come on.
Come on, students. Let's share. We're so proud of you all. We've had a great year, and we're just going out on a really, really good note for the Lord, because we're going to start out in 2021 just on fire for God, on fire for his people and his kingdom to get the word out there. He had to take another sip to get the word of the Lord out there where it needs to be. And we can't keep it hid. We have to share.
Amen. Thank you so much for your obedience. And I pray right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that every person who obeyed the word that I just spoke as far as sharing, liking, amen, this broadcast, I ask right now that you will bless them 100-fold.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen. So there we are with the nerves in our hands and feet connecting to the organs in our body, all over our body, are connected to nerve endings in our hands and our feet. Therefore, when we clap our hands, we are giving ourselves life. No longer again will we think we're expending all of our energy by clapping or standing on our feet, but we're standing, we're building our circulation, and we're clapping and helping our nerves and our circulation of our body to cleanse all the organs in our body.
Yes.
Wow, we praise our God. I can see it as a way of just giving God thanks and praise for the way that he created us, giving him honor for the beauty in this creation that we call our bodies.
Yes.
thanking him and being appreciative for all that he does, for the magnificent way that he put us together. Whereas, have y'all ever wondered how this body just continues to renew itself? All the different processes that go on in our individual bodies that keep us alive, amazing. That keep us going. It's simply amazing, Pastor.
Yes, it is.
It's amazing. So the fact that we found out that our hands and feet are attached to nerves in the organs in our bodies is just simply amazing. A work of only our Father, our Creator could do.
What I just heard was, when she just described it, what I just heard was, it's a blessing to bless God.
Wow. It's a blessing to bless God. It is.
It's a blessing to bless God. We're dealing with the biblical forms of praise. We're dealing with standing,
wow,
and clapping our hands. So we're standing, wow, which is a biblical form of praise, meaning we're blessing God. We're clapping our hands, wow, which is a biblical form of praise. We're blessing God. So what's happening is, while we're blessing God, we're being blessed. So it is a blessing to bless God.
Is it
possible that some of us are not walking in blessings
we're
not
blessing God? Oh, God. Ooh. Man, you better preach in here.
Is it possible that the more we bless God, the more we are blessed? Yes. And so is it possible that we're not as blessed as we desire to be, or we're not as blessed as we imagine ourselves that we ought to be? Is it possible that we're not walking in the blessing that we envision and or dream about? Is because we are not blessing God. Wow. The Bible says it is more blessed to give than
to receive.
So while we're giving unto God, he is giving unto us. It's a song saying you can't be God given, wow, no matter how hard you try. In other words, it's a blessing in blessing God.
Ooh, that's it.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
It's a blessing in blessing him. It's a blessing to my body. It's a blessing to my hands, to my feet. It's a blessing to my organs. It's a blessing to my mind. It's a blessing to my family, because when I'm doing better, when I'm feeling better, my family is feeling better. We're able to come together and to think and to have a good environment.
To my soul, it's a blessing.
Oh my goodness.
To my soul. Amen. It's a blessing to my soul. It's a blessing to us emotionally. Amen. It's a blessing to us financially. Come on, y'all.
My.
It's a blessing to bless God. So that's why some of us broke right now, because we stingy. We don't want to bless. We'll bless boo-boo and foo-foo nil before we'll be a blessing to God. And now we mad because we in debt. Now we mad because the phone finna be cut off. Now we mad because we don't have any gas money. Mad because they want to give us $600 stimulus. Hey, come on, somebody. But no, it's a blessing being a blessing.
Blessing to God.
To God. Amen. Amen. So let us be found blessing God. Wow. We're coming into 2021. I want to come in giving God the glory. I want to come in giving God the praise. I want to come in giving God the honor. Why? Because it is a blessing, blessing God.
Thank you, God. That's it. That thing just got in my spirit. I knew it was important. I know that I always feel led. I'm a praiser. I'm a worshiper.
I knew that
it was important to bless him. But until my studies, y'all, I'm telling you, this series has blessed me. Knowing that my hands and my feet have nerves that are attached, the endings are attached to my organ.
Uh-huh.
So it's a blessing to bless God. It's a blessing to me to bless him. It's a blessing to my whole being, to my whole man, like he said, emotionally, financially, everything that I do to bless God. That's where the song came from. You can't be God-given no matter how you try. It's a blessing to bless him. It's a blessing to give unto him. It's a blessing to be a servant of him, a servant in his kingdom, to serve his people, to serve the church, to do his will in our lives. It's just a blessing to bless God. It's a blessing to be able to clap my hands. Somebody doesn't have hands. It's a blessing to be able to stand. Somebody doesn't have legs. It's a blessing to be able to sing. Somebody can't talk, doesn't have a voice. But God, I bless you. I thank you for showing me in your word the forms of praise. I thank you for showing me how important it is for me to bless you. I thank you for showing me how the relationship between you and I build as I bless you, God. How everything increases as I give more of myself to you. You give more to me. The more and more that I bless God, the more he continues to show up in my life and to provide revelation into the things that I never understood before. The things that I was lacking in because of my praise, because of me blessing him. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. There it is in the Message translation again. I will bless God every chance that I get. My lungs expand with his praise. Now I can say that my hands and my feet give me life when I bless him. I give myself life, more life, extended life, when I bless the Lord.
So that explains why our 89-year-old mothers in the church are able to shout and dance do because they've been praising God all their life.
Extending their life.
They've been blessing God, so he's been blessing them.
That means I'm going to live a long time. Yes!
Amen. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Those mothers, when they walk in the church, they look like they're about to fall over. But when the praise and the worship
Yes.
Amen. They up, they clapping, they shouting, they dancing around the house of the Lord like they 30 years old. Hear what I'm saying?
Thank you, God.
Blessing God blesses us.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Clapping our hands and standing in the house of the Lord, singing Zion songs to him, songs from the heart. It may not even be a song that Israel wrote or that Brother Fred Hammond wrote or Psalmist Rain wrote, but Yolanda Adams wrote.
That's Sister Wilson's. That's her artist, Yolanda Adams.
Yeah, it may not be a song that they wrote, but it's a song from our heart straight to God. Sometimes I make up songs. A lot of times. I'll take a song or one comes in my heart and I just make it my own. And at that moment, that's a song of praise from my heart to God. Giving him praise, that's the most important thing. We don't even understand all that goes into blessing God. When we bless him, he sees our heart. He sees our efforts. He sees what we're giving, our sacrifice unto him. And God blesses our sacrifice. I'm a witness that God truly blesses our sacrifices. So let's not be afraid to give and to pour out to him. Let's not be self-conscious and worried about who's looking at us or who's saying what or thinking what. I'm praising my God. He's been too good to me for me not to praise him.
On that note, dealing with our sacrifices unto God, we want to take this moment, amen, to prepare our hearts and minds to sow seed, financial seed,
yes,
into the kingdom of God. You sown unto him tonight with your mind, your time. That was a noble offering unto the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. And so now we want to take a moment to sow financially.
That's it.
Any amount into the house of God. We're not beggars. No, we're not. But we want you to sow seed of any amount. The reason why I say any amount, because a lot of times the devil try to make us feel like, well, you only have this. They're going to laugh at you, or this is not worth anything. But that's contrary to the word, because when we give from our heart, God honors it.
Yes.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? So somebody may be able to give whatever they're able to give freely with no second thought.
Yes.
God honors it. Then it may be somebody, this is their last. They say, I want to sow some of my last to the house of God. Or I want to give my last, whatever it may be.
Yes.
God honors our sacrifices. So you see the various ways in which you are able to sow here. We say sow into this anointing.
Yes.
Amen. Here at Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries. God is a great God. God is an amazing God. And we thank him for what he is doing, not only in our lives personally, but in our lives collectively.
Yes.
He keeps on
blessing us. Everybody is not strung out or, let me see, hard for money. Everybody's not
hard up
for money. No. We're not just sowing a seed to get more money. Somebody, as I stated last week, and I say it all the time, we may be sowing a seed for peace of mind.
For good health.
Good health, a good night rest. We may be sowing a seed, amen, for our children to be saved, for our children's future. We may, whatever it may be the case, when you sow your seed, put an assignment on your seed and say, Lord, I'm sowing this seed, amen, so that this will take place in the name of Jesus. And then you sow by faith.
Thank you, God.
And we're trusting and believing. We're trusting and agreeing with you according to the will of God, to the word of God, that it shall come to pass. In the name of Jesus. So sow with expectation. Don't just give to give. Amen. But give with a level of expectation that God is going to do what you're asking him to do. Some of us, we don't need anything from God. We're just like, Lord, I thank you.
Thank you.
And so I'm sowing into this ministry. I'm sowing into Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries. We praise God for it because, listen, when we bless God, he blesses us. We're givers.
Yes.
And so I was sharing with somebody not long ago. I said, listen, it seems like the more I give out of my closet.
Yes.
I'm not saying this for y'all to be like, ooh, Pastor, we give it. No. It's not even about that, I promise you. We do more than y'all see on social media.
Yeah.
But it's like the more I give out of my closet, y'all, I may see a young man or whatever be the case, and I'm like, you know what, I'm going to give you this suit, or I'm going to give you this whatever, okay? And it's like the more I give, the more I have in my closet.
Yeah.
I'm serious, y'all. The more I take out my closet to bless somebody else, it seems like the more is in my closet, okay? And so what am I saying? We cannot be God-giving no matter how hard we try. So we want to sow it to good ground tonight. I'm saying this. This is the end of the year. Okay, this is Tuesday, the last Tuesday of the year.
Yes.
Okay, the next time we see y'all will be Thursday night, the Lord's will.
Yes.
The world's still spinning and we still on it. Amen, amen. So we want to maximize this moment. We want to take advantage of this opportunity that God has given us. And we want to sow a seed into this ministry. I need you to get in your heart and mind what you want to give. And I need you to do it now and do it quickly. Do not allow the enemy to come with distractions, to come with doubt, amen, to come with frustration. Well, you know all you can do. Say to the Lord, rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I'm going to give on tonight because I understand when I give, I receive. When I open my hand, I receive. It's a story, y'all. About this monkey, Dr. Clay, that I heard about in the jungle. They were trying to catch this monkey in the jungle. And so what they did was they knew that the monkey liked shiny things. And so they put this shiny object in the cage. And it got a hold on it, a hole in the cage. Where the monkey can stick his hand through and grab this object. But the object is too big to pull out of the cage.
Yeah.
And so what they did was, this is a true story, y'all. He stuck his hand in the cage to grab the object. And he went to pull his hand out, he couldn't get his hand out because he was holding on to this big object.
Wow.
And the people who set the trap were able to get the monkey and do what they want, kill him or whatever they was trying to do to him. And the reason why they was able to do that is because he wouldn't let go. He was struggling to hold on to this object. But if he had let the object go, he would have been free.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Wow.
And he would have still had his life. But because he didn't want to let go, the people who set the trap for him were able to get to him and ultimately destroy him. So the moral of the story is sometimes we got to let go. We sit there holding on and creeping on to this. No, God said, let it go. I can't just let it go. And let me be a blessing to you. Can't nothing get in my head by being closed. Can't nothing get in and can't nothing get out. I'm harming myself.
Yeah.
Open your hand. Be a blessing to the kingdom of God. And I guarantee you, God will be a blessing back to you. Give and it shall be given. Press down, shake it together, and run it over. Shall be and give unto your bosom. Whatever measure you use in giving, that same measure will be used to give back to you. And we're praying right now for a 100-fold return.
That's good, Pastor.
In the name of Jesus.
That's it.
Amen.
That's it. God bless your seeds. God bless your giving. God bless your heart because of your sacrifice. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Well, we're going to pray on tonight. We're going to ask for God's covering over our families. If you have something that you need prayer for, you can inbox us on the page, facebook.com/APWM Conway. If you need personal prayer and you want to talk to a pastor or myself, call us, 870-727-0061. If you don't want to end this year without having a committed church home, look no further. You're home. Call us, 870-727-0061. We'll talk with you, pray with you, get you plugged in as part of the Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries family. We love you and we want you to be covered. God says in his word in 3 John, I wish above all things that you would prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. So he wants us to prosper across the board in everything that we do. Lord, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for this very moment in time that we will never see again. God, we pray that today is used for your glory and your honor. We give you honor. We give you praise. We magnify your holy name.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you for every person who is tuned in with us on tonight. We thank you for those who shall come later and watch this broadcast.
Yes.
God, we thank you that the anointing that is on us now will still be flowing no matter when a person catches in on this broadcast. God, we thank you that you are touching the minds and the lives of your people.
Yes.
We thank you for every man, woman, boy, and girl. We thank you for the families represented right here. We thank you that you're building the bonds of our family units. You're touching our emotions. You're bringing us into stability. You're healing our minds. You're healing us from the inside out. And God, we praise you. We thank you for building relationship with us through praise and worship, teaching us the principles of this thing, the laws, the commands that we have to go by in order to get in your presence. God, we thank you for healing us. We thank you for salvation.
Yes.
We thank you for deliverance. We thank you for sending your son Jesus into the world to show us how to live so that we could be saved. We thank you for him dying, him choosing to die on the cross for us, so that we can have a chance at eternal life. God, we praise you for eternal life. We thank you for still being able to live in this world around amongst all the evil, but still yet be saved from our sin and saved from the world. So God, continue to help our minds. Help us in this walk with you. We bind Satan who comes to try to play tricks and games in our minds. Satan, the Lord rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We belong to God. Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name, we all say amen and amen.
Amen. We thank God for you on the screen. It says, accept Christ today.
Yes.
Amen. If you want to make Jesus your Lord and Savior, yes, call our office. 870-727-0061. If you're looking for a church home,
yes,
call our office. The information is there. We're here for you. God has allowed us to be in this earth as a gift to you, to the body of Christ. And we thank God for this opportunity.
Yes.
Stay tuned. Amen. Don't hang up. Amen. Don't hang up your phone.
Don't hang up.
Amen. Don't turn off your television. Don't close your laptop.
Yes.
We have one announcement left for you. We praise God for you. We look forward to seeing you all this Thursday, 7 p.m. or at 11 p.m. Central Standard Time on Facebook Live.
Yes.
For the crossover.
The crossover. See you then.
God bless you. We love you.
Time I have. That's why I want to take the time to say thank you.